ఓం సుషుమ్నా.
ఓం సుషుమ్నా అన్నపూర్ణ.
డాక్టర్ మధుశ్రీ గారు, కెన్ యూ ప్లీజ్ షేర్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ విత్ అవర్ పరమ గురు పూజ్య శ్రీ 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 మహాతర్ బాబాజీ గారు టుడే?
యా, డెఫినెట్లీ ఐ విల్ షేర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ వన్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ విచ్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ డ్యూరింగ్ ద గురు పౌర్ణిమ 2009. సో ఇన్ ద ఇయర్ 2009 వీ వర్ ఇన్వైటెడ్ బై మహాతర్ బాబాజీ గారు. That is our Pujya Guru Atmanandamayi Mataji Garu has received an invitation from Mahavatar Babaji Garu asking her to come along with her disciples to Kotralam. And Mahavatar Babaji Garu said that he would be coming with his gurus. And his gurus Bogna Siddhar and Agastya Mahamuni. So after we got this news, we just googled for Kotralam because it was the first time we heard that name. And then we found that that place was of a great scenic beauty. It has a lot of natural beauty and it was a tourist spot. My son Nagateja had a lot of passion for natural beauty. He likes to spend a lot of time in the nature.
Okay.
And he was also available at that time, like he didn't have any major exams or anything to take up at that particular time. So we all planned together. And one day before the Guru Purnima, that night I requested my son to just enter the meditation hall because Nagateja never meditated till then.
Okay.
So he was saying, I have not never meditated, maybe I can't meditate. So I told him, it's okay. If you don't meditate also, it's okay. Just enter into the hall and if you want to sleep, sleep. No one is going to object. Because my intention then was, see such great masters like Agastya Mahamuni, and Bhogna Siddhar, Mahavatar Babaji himself gracing the occasion. So I thought even a sight of theirs on my son would give him lot of energies.
Very, very true.
So the same thing explained to him and luckily he acknowledged and both of us reached the hall the next day. That time Amagaru also had given us an instruction. So she had said that all of us to reach the hall before 6 a.m. and we have to be in a meditative state. Because she cautioned us that if you are not in a meditation state, then it will be very difficult for us to withstand the energies of those high masters.
Okay.
So, on advice of instruction of Mataji Garu, all of us entered the hall before 6 a.m. Because that time, Mahavatar Babaji Garu also has given us a message that we need to meditate for 2 hours 20 minutes in a stretch. The time was from 6 a.m. in the morning to 8:20 a.m. in the morning, 6 a.m. to 8:20 a.m. So all of us were there and in the hall there was a clock which would be striking, the one which strikes one, two, it makes a music sound. So there was a clock like that. As we entered the hall, as you know, our custom is, our tradition is all the men, gentlemen sit to one side and all the ladies sit to one side. So I asked my son to go and make his place among the gentlemen and I made my place in the ladies. And then I forgot everything about my son. I went into meditation. I heard the clock strike 6. Then a strong ball of energy hit me. And after a short gap, successively 3 large balls of energies hit me. And after the last ball hit me, suddenly I had darshan of Mahavatar Babaji Garu in my meditation.
Wow.
I was actually sitting in front of him and meditating.
Wow. That was a marvelous experience.
It was marvelous, but I was a little frightened. I thought I was imagining.
Okay.
Because someone like me sitting in front of Babaji and meditating, that too on the auspicious day of Guru Purnima.
Guru Purnima, yes.
So I could not believe myself. What I did is I thought I'm imagining and I slowly shifted my concentration from Brahmacha for a short while and then I brought it back to the Brahmacha.
Okay.
And when I brought it back to the Brahmacha, Babaji Garu was sitting steadily as he was previously only. So now I just gathered all my senses together and I sat straight and I went into meditation. So that whole time I was meditating in the presence of Mahavatar Babaji Garu.
Wow. So blessed you are.
Suddenly, I saw my son coming towards us. He was pulling a large wooden cart on his shoulders. And in the cart there were large bags, very, very large bags with their mouths tightly tied with the rope.
You mean this was in the hall?
No, no, in my meditation.
Okay.
This is all in the meditation. I am still in the meditation only.
Okay.
So, in the meditation, I was meditating sitting in front of Mahatar Babaji Garu. And in that place where I was meditating along with Mahatar Babaji Garu, I saw my son coming towards me.
Oh.
And he was pulling a large wooden cart on his shoulders. And that cart was filled with very, very large bags, very huge bags. And the mouth of the bags was tightly closed with ropes.
Okay.
And it was not just one or two bags, there were multiple bags in the cart. So, Babaji was in front of me and both of us were meditating. He just passed across us, and the moment he crossed us, he left the cart. He just left the cart, and then the cart and Nagateja disappeared. They vanished from our sight.
Okay.
I now saw all the bags neatly piled in front of Babaji. All those huge bags, they were neatly piled. See, he was carrying the cart, and when you overturn the cart, what happens to the bags? They have to roll down.
Yes.
And spill all over. But they have not spilled out. They were just lying very neatly in front of Babaji Garu. Then, immediately, from my inner side, my inner voice, it was telling, "Oh Teja, how lucky you are. My, how lucky you are, Teja, you're very lucky." 3 times it repeated. Then now I started thinking with my physical mind.
Okay.
What did Teja do? What is that he actually carried for the masters? What is the service he did for the masters by which I feel that he was very lucky? I was pondering on that thought. Suddenly, Amagaru also had said, "Okay." At the same time, everything was happening simultaneously. Amagaru said, "Okay." And immediately, Babaji manifested into a very huge tree. It was a very, very huge tree. And I felt as if the whole world can come under it. It was such huge tree. And the moment I saw the tree, that was what which struck me. The whole world can come under it.
Wow.
And since our meditation has been finished, because Amagaru said, "Okay," we came out of meditation. And as I came out of meditation, Prashanti Amma, you know, our Guru Mata's sister, Prashanti Amma approached me and she said, "Today, Nagateja has meditated wonderfully." So I said, "Amma, Nagateja never meditated. I don't think he meditated also, because he have never meditated before." Then Prashanti Amma said, "See, this is not what I am telling. The moment we came out of meditation, the first sentence which Guru Mata has spoken is, 'Today Nagateja has meditated wonderfully.' This is a statement of Mataji Garu. It is not me making the statement." When we both were talking like this, my son approached us. Then I asked him, "Teja, did you meditate?" Then he said, "Amma, I don't know anything. I think I slept." "Why are you saying like that?" I asked him. He said, "Amma, I sat with yoga mudra. I heard the clock 6 striking, but I did not hear the 7. Again, I heard the clock striking 8.
Oh.
So, that means I must have slept. I don't know anything. This is what I did." Then I said, "No, it seems you meditated very well." Amagaru was telling that. He just said, "No, I don't know. Maybe I don't know anything. I don't know if I meditated or slept. I don't know anything." That was what he stated. Then later, after on the same day, when I had an opportunity to talk to Mataji Garu, I expressed all my vision to Mataji Garu, and then I asked her, "What is that Teja carried to Mahatar Babaji Garu?" Then Amagaru asked me, "Do you remember the conversation which we had a day before you left to Kotralam?" So on the day I was leaving, before the day I was leaving, so one day before, I had a conversation with Mataji Garu, a telephonic conversation. And then I said, "Yes, Amma, I remember. You were telling me that this time in Kotralam, there will be a special homam being performed wherein the gurus will be burning off the karmas of Sushumna Kriya Yoga Sadhakas."
Oh.
So Amagaru said, "Yes." And the large bags which Teja carried and left in front of Mahatar Babaji are all his karmas.
Oh my God.
I was taken back. I was astonished. There was no words for me to speak. Because I have seen the large size of the bags. They were huge, so huge and multiple in numbers.
Those were the amount of karmas of a single person.
Of a single person. And then Amagaru said, this is a group message. So all those who have meditated today and have attended the homam being performed, all of you have left off so many karmas. You have all got rid of so many karmas, such huge karmas. That is the uniqueness, importance and amazing thing of the homam which is being performed every year during Guru Purnima. So this happens every year. This is not just for that particular year. Actually, 2009, the first homam has started. And then, I think you must have attended also. I remember you have attended one or two Guru Purnimas.
I started from 2016.
Yeah, that's what. I remember you were there sometime with us during Guru Purnima.
Yes, yes.
So anyone who has attended the Guru Purnima and have participated in the homam, all of us are getting rid of so many karmas without going through those results, without actually suffering, we are being rid of those karmas. And again, Amagaru has said that out of 7 parts of the karma, 6 parts of the karma are burnt off by gurus in that homam. So we are only undergoing, we the Sushumna Kriya Yoga Sadhakas, we are only undergoing 1 part out of 7 parts of the karmas. So when you calculate roughly, it will come to around 15% or less than 50% of the karmas we are undergoing, and about 85% of the karmas are being burned down by the gurus in the homa.
That is true, Dr. Madhushree Garu.
Like, it's so amazing. Like who can be blessed with such a great opportunity? No? Because till now, what we know is, no one can escape karma. Guru, any master tells us the same. No one can escape the karma. You have to go through the results of your karma. But when it comes to Sushumna Kriya Yoga Sadhakasa,
I think it's the benevolence that they are taking away our karmas. It's not a simple thing to take our karmas and burn them.
And that too, 85% of the karmas every year.
That is very true.
Amazing. Because that was the first homam, 2009 Kotralam was the first homam being performed. So, gurus, they gave me that vision. Like, they made a sakshi. They made me a sakshi for actually what was happening then.
You had a great blessing.
It's not just me, Annapurna.
So
it's a group message. All of us.
Yes, but you had the darshan of what gurus were doing to us.
I can definitely tell you that I was lucky, double lucky, triple lucky also, I can tell you, because on that auspicious day of Guru Purnima, I had the opportunity to meditate sitting in front of Mahatar Babaji Garu for 2 hours, 20 minutes.
That's not a small thing.
Yeah, really. That was a great blessing which Babaji Garu has bestowed on me. And then coming to the next question of mine, that why did Babaji Garu manifest into a big tree? Yeah. So for that, Mataji Garu had said that, you're only giving the answer. I didn't know. You were telling me that the whole world can come under the tree. Yes, Amagaru, I felt like that. The moment I saw the tree, that was which struck me. As if the whole world can get under the tree. Yes, Babaji Garu is so huge. He's so huge that he can accommodate the whole world under his grace, under his arms, under the umbrella of his blessings.
Wow.
And then Amagaru also said that the whole tree was empty. So she said, now it is your duty. You got a message from Babaji Garu that you should start filling the tree.
Oh my God.
Filling the space beneath the tree. Then she said, it's not you. This is all a group message. So it's a message to the whole group of Sushumna Kriya Yoga Sadhakas. Babaji Garu standing with his arms wide open. Now come. Gather as many as you can. Is the message which we have got.
Truly, as you're saying this, I feel some vibrations in my body. Like I feel some expansion in my Anahata Chakra.
It's amazing, amazing, really amazing. There are no words. That's what I always tell to when I share my experience or whenever there's a satsang or when I get an opportunity to speak of our gurus. I conclude saying that I just can't express. It's beyond expression. You have to experience it.
Exactly.
No words can actually describe what our gurus are. You have to experience it. The moment one experiences, they cannot take a U-turn at all. They just get tied on. That is the divinity of our gurus. That is the love they are showering on all of us. Immense love, unconditional love,
yes.
Is what we are enjoying from our great gurus.
Very true, very true. Thank you, Dr. Madhushree Garu, for sharing your experience. It was a very, very wonderful one, and you have showed us. Like through your experience, you have made us realize the amount of karmas we are carrying from our previous births and how gurus are just taking them away.
Yeah.
With such unconditional love.
Something unbelievable. But we have to experience it.
Very true. Because these kinds are unheard earlier.
Yeah. Exactly. They're not heard till data.
Exactly.
But it's the truth. The truth and only the truth. Any Sushumna Kriya Yoga Sadhaka will experience this. The great, great masters. I prostrate at the holy feet of my Guru Mata, the Pratyaksha Parabrahma, Karana Swarupini, Pujasri Atmanandamai Mataji Garu, with unshaken belief, utmost surrenderance and unconditional gratitude to her holy feet for bestowing the supreme knowledge of truth to me in a very simple way. Om Sushumna.
Om Sushumna. Thank you, Dr. Madhushree Garu, for sharing your experience.
It's all our gurus. I'm just an instrument.
Thank you so much.